All right, guys, you asked for it. You wanted to post your video on how to make your own poster at home, turning this into this. Now, this one is actually one that I printed at Office Max, but we can also achieve something very similar printing at home. And I have two programs today to show you how to do it, just in case one decides to go away, then you'll have the other one to fall back on. All right, let's go ahead and get started. Okay, first step is that you're going to need your PDF to be turned into images. And so we are going to start at smallpdf.com. You're going to go over to tools, and then you're going to go down. We're going to actually click on see all PDF tools. And we are going to pick PDF to JPEG. We are going to choose our file. So you're going to upload your PDF. I'm using my free anchor chart. Wait just a minute, and it will populate all of your pages into images. Make sure you pick the first one because the second one costs money, but the first one is free and it's exactly what we need. All right, from here, you can just go download. The little arrow button is download, and you can click on the exact page that you want. So we're going to download it, and then we are ready to utilize. I have two different websites for you. So the first is called Rastrobator.net. We're going to click on create your poster, and see here, you're going to upload that image that we just downloaded. So you stick it in, you press upload, and then it shows you what it looks like. And I kind of really like this one because it shows the guy next to it. So it shows like how big it is. And it kind of also shows you how many you can pick how many sheets. So I only want mine to be 2 sheets wide. And so it can show you how much smaller it is. You also want to go ahead and have your margins on each side. So if you want, you can include your crop marks. You can also include the page position so that you know exactly where each page goes. Now it does show that like you can pay if you want, but you don't have to. So you'll see that it downloaded, and I really like, I know that some people, so it shows your cut marks and it kind of overlaps. So that's one of the things about these is that it's going to overlap. One of the things that I like about using this tool and it separating it for you, sometimes people complain that they have some white pages left, and this allows you to only print the pages you need. You'll also see up there at the top that it's kind of grayed out, and that's because we've printed it as an image. And so it is going to print kind of more gray versus white. So I like the Rastrobator because it shows you how big it's going to be next to the person, but I actually prefer this Posterazor if your background is white, because it's not going to print your background white as gray. All right, so we go to Posterazor, and we are going to go over here and click on the little file folder, find our image that we want to print. Once we click next, we can choose if we want it portrait, if we want it landscape, how big we want our borders to be. So I actually kind of played with this, and I think that you should stick with the 1.5. Okay, so here you can choose you want your size in pages or your size in percent. And so I'm just going to do my size in percent because I know that I want it to be 250%. And then we're going to click save, and it's going to be kind of just like the other one where it saves as a PDF, and you'll be able to tell that it is white, and when it prints, it does not use ink. So that's one of the reasons why I really like that. And then you'll be able to tell that as you look at it, that it overlaps. So it doesn't have that border that you have to cut off like when you do it in Adobe. Instead, you're going to kind of glue on top of it, and you will have a border. Thank you so much for following along with me. I really hope that that was helpful. I know that so many of you are frustrated that Adobe now has, you know, the printing from a poster is a paid option. And I can't help that they've changed their software. And honestly, these websites also might change their software. I have no control over that. But for now, this is our best option. And I really hope that it was helpful for you guys. If you would like more videos on tips and tricks, mostly for teachers as well as classroom management hacks, go ahead and like and subscribe so that you don't miss any future videos.